Okay, guys, welcome back to Knickknacks Presents Mass Effect 2. I just did a whole intro for this, and as soon as I got done with the intro, broadcast failed. So, hopefully it'll hold this time. If you want to see in the last episode, then go watch the last episode. So I'm not going to go through all of that again. Here's the codex entry we got in our conversation with Samara. Ardet Yakshi, Demon of the Night Winds, are Asari suffering from a genetic disorder preventing conventional melding of nervous systems during mating. Instead, Ardet Yakshi electrochemically ravage their partner's nervous systems, in extreme cases, leaving victims as vegetative invalids or corpses. Asari psychologists regard this incapacity for mental fusion as preventing the development of empathy, leading to psychopathy. There is no known cure. The disorder begins in infancy, reaching full pathology during maiden-adolescent sexual development. While seductive and sexually driven as other Asari, Ardet Yakshi are congenitally sterile. Another ancient Asari mythology held Ardet Yakshi as gods of destruction, depicting them as villains of countless legends and as the anti-heroes of numerous Asari epics. Contrary to popular belief, Ardet Yakshi are neither extremely rare, found in 1% of Asari on the AY spectrum. Around 1% of Asari dwell on the AY spectrum, nor are they all murderers. Most cultivate and discard countless exploitative or abusive relationships during their legally marginal lives. Despite rumors of Ardet Yakshi syndicates, by nature, Ardet Yakshi are incapable of long-term cooperation. As a disproportionately wealthy species, Asari employ their economic reach and media ownership to hide the AY pathology from the galactic community, placing most Ardet Yakshi in monitored work programs or seclusion. Only the most aggressive cases are sentenced to sanitaria and prisons or to the execution lists of Justicars. See, even I was thinking as we were having the conversation with Samara that they came back and retconned Ardet Yakshi then, because you go to a monastery for Ardet Yakshi in that game, and it's implied that there are way more Ardet Yakshi than, whereas in this one she says that there are only three. But even in the codex entry there, it tells you that there are a lot more than just three Ardet Yakshi.
People are talking out there, and I hear it all.
So I'm not sure what the answer to that
I'm
is.
I'm not really sure what to do with myself. Not much call for thievery aboard a ship. Not a lot of people go in and out of Dr. Chakwa's office, other than to get medical attention, I mean. I hear you shared a drink with her. That's really nice. I imagine with all that's happened, old friends are becoming a luxury. Gabby and Ken would make a great couple. I just doubt they'll ever realize it.
And I forgot to set the timer. There we go. So we'll be a little long.
Come back later. I'm sure I'll have more to talk about.
Probably only a couple minutes.
Commander, what can I do for you?
Anything I should know regarding...
The crew's working well, and the ship appears to be performing to specifications.
Do you have a minute, Miranda?
There's a lot to do, Shepard. Maybe...
I'll let you work.
Of course, Commander.
I can't believe the Collectors were once Protheans.
I always pictured Protheans being regal, not giant bugs.
Who knows what the Reapers did to them? Creepy.
Okay, I think that's the last of what we have to do on this deck. Go down and check in with Gabby and Ken, and with Zaid.
think we'll make it through this?
Of course we will, Gabby.
I mean, as long as we take down the collectors, it's all worth it. Even if we don't make it.
Don't even think that. We'll make it through.
And I always forget which side Zaid's on and which side Grunt's on.
Back for another lesson. Collectors and Protheans. It's all about my pay grade. I'm more used to putting down rebellions, tracking down bastards who didn't pay their gambling debts. Still, even I know a galaxy-shaking revelation when I hear one. Makes fighting land wars for pay seem small time. Nice ship you got here. Roomy. Last ship I worked on, two men couldn't walk past each other in the hall unless they were really good friends. I should let you go. Talk more later.
All right, now back up to the CIC.
No messages for you, Commander.
Well, there shouldn't be. I haven't done anything since last time. Alrighty then. Refuel. Stock back up on probes. Alright, now let's see. Yeah, this is Tali's. We're gonna go ahead and recruit Tali now. So that we have our full complement. You're in Haystrom. Haystrom, formerly a Quarian colony, Haystrom was established to observe the phenomenon on Dolan, the planet's parent star. Dolan appeared to be unstable with a high possibility of erupting prematurely into a red giant. Haystrom was lost to the Geth in 1896 CE. Soon after, all communication from the planet and its attendant space station ceased. The Geth have shown no signs of treating Dolan as a threat over the past three centuries, other than establishing several space stations near it. Dolan's magnetic eruptions and their solar output overwhelm most communication near it, and it is unclear how the Geth have compensated. Today, spy probe scans indicate extensive orbital construction around Haystrom, housing thousands of Geth platforms and an unknown number of Geth software mines. It is not known how many Geth are on the planet's surface. Spy probes face interference from Dolan, making remote scanning difficult. Resource estimations based on Geth mining, refining, and fabrication practices suggest that the planet has at least 20 more years of use before it is exhausted. Intelligence experts speculate that the Geth have not exploited all of their resources because they wish to keep some in reserve for repairs. Travel advisory. Haystrom is a Geth stronghold. Military spy drones using cutting-edge stealth technology are the only vehicles that have returned unharmed from Geth space. All civilian traffic is prohibited. Okay, well, I'm sure that Tali is not in any trouble here at all as a Quarian on a Geth military stronghold. So this is one of the first chances we have to actually fight Geth in this game. After they were the big bads of the first game, now we barely get the chance to run into them in this one. So, for our Geth fighting duties, we are going to take Garrus Vakarian and Zaid Masani. Don't think I've taken either of these guys out in a while. Yeah. Yep, so I will pump more into his passive. And for Zaid, we are definitely going to take the disruptor ammo. Give it the squad option so that we all get the effects of disruptor ammo, and we will just tear these geth apart. The extra damage that does to both shields and synthetics. And put an additional 3 into his class. Alright. Before we do anything else, let's get everyone hooked up on disruptor ammo for everything.
Change weapon.
Changing weapon.
Disruptor ammo again. And what is it that I don't? My machine pistol. Oh, heavy pistol, which I probably won't be using at all, but why not?
Shields are overheating, Shepard.
If we stay in the shade, we should be fine.
Wow. This is uncomfortable.
Drop!
Alright, where are you?
There's gonna be a better way through here. We're burning up.
This should come in handy.
Nice, Tempest. I was wondering how long it was before we finally got an upgrade.
This is Commander Shepard of the Normandy. Can we provide assistance? Team. How many of you are left?
We were a small squad, dozen Marines plus the science team. We're down to half strength still. Made the synthetic bastards pay for it, though.
It's not good.
Brought you this deep into Geth controlled space.
You're asking the wrong person, Shepard. I just point and shoot. Something about the sun is going bad faster than it should. Some kind of energy.
Any idea where the Geth came from?
One of the patrol ships allowed us. Drop ships started raining Geth down on our heads before we could get off the world. Systems under Geth control. We hope going low emissions would hide us.
Do we have to worry about the Geth sending in reinforcements?
I don't think so. Our patrol ship hasn't let off again. The radiation blocks all off-world communication.
How
are you holding up? We can be there in a few minutes.
Take it slow and careful. Direct sunlight fries your shield. Hell, we're bunkered down at base camp across the valley. I left Tally's already secure shield. Double back to all the choke point. Getting Tally on sales is our top priority. If you can extract your
got confirmation that the Geth haven't reached Tally yet?
Affirmative. Left my best men with her. When you get here, you can talk to her on the comm. Every Marine on this rock is sworn to protect Tally Zora. As long as one of us is just as long as she is.
You're gonna throw your life away for research?
Negative. I give my life for the migrant fleet, all the difference in the world. I'm no tech expert, Shepard. They tell me to shoot. I shoot. They said to protect Tally and the data. You get him out safe, I've done my job.
Hold position. We'll hit their back ranks.
Coming in. time to clear a path.
Shepard, I have scanned the area and located the demolition charges. Quarry commander mentioned.
Put it on my radar.
Done. You will need both sets of charges to clear the rubble.
I'll take the shot.
Okay, back over the sniper rifles for this.
The soldier said to use mining charges to blow through this rubble. I'm on it.
Okay. There's another one. Okay. And the Geth Prime, fun as always.
I'm on it. I'm going.
Alright guys, run for it. Already, Oh, not that one.
impossible to get accurate solar measurements. The radiation keeps burning out our equipment. This sun shouldn't be like this. It was stable a few hundred years ago. Stars don't die that quickly.
Okay, apparently this was not the right way to go. Okay, let's try the other direction then, shall we? Yeah, of course, here it is. All right, sprint. Got that. Okay. Now let's see if we can do this.
Let's move before it blows.
That really wasn't very impressive from two demolition charges.
Quarians come this far into Geth territory.
Telly, it's Shepard. I'm sorry, everyone here is dead. Any survivors must have fallen back.
We knew this mission was high risk. Damn it.
And what are you doing here, Shepard? We're in the middle of Geth space.
I was in the neighborhood. I thought you might need a hand.
Thanks for coming, Shepard. It means a lot to hear your voice. Call Rieger.
Tally!
What's this research you're after?
It's about this world's sun. It's aging faster than it should. I can tell you more about it once we've got fewer Geth shooting at us.
Would it help if I brought in the Normandy?
Doubtful. These buildings are centuries old. If you bring down heavy fire, this whole place could collapse on us.
There's always a reason why we can't just bring the Normandy in.
Is anyone else still with you?
Still with
you?
Are you alone out there?
It looks like somebody sealed the door against the Geth and the console is damaged. Can you get it open your end?
Let me see. Yes, I can do it. Here. Should be unlocked now. Be careful, Shepard, and please do what you can to keep Rieger alive.
Copy that, Tally.
They've seen us.
Hell of a shot. Hell yeah.
My pleasure. I got one. In there we get. One less to worry about.
Got no shield.
I guess. Ready for another push? Funny how these wall safes that have been in here for hundreds of years can be cracked the exact same way as modern safes.
Someone's firing rockets at you. The Geth are near platoon strength, but the Colossus is the worst part. It's got a repair protocol. huddles up and fixes itself. I can't get a clear shot while it's down like that. I tried to move in closer, but one of the bastards punched a shot clean through my suit.
How bad is your suit damage?
Combat seals clamped down to isolate contamination, and I'm swimming in antibiotics. Geth might get me, but I'm not gonna die from an infection in the middle of a battle. That's just insulting.
What can you tell me about the battlefield?
Right side's got a catwalk with a sniper perch. You could wreak some havoc from there. None of my men made it past the Geth. Middle's got cover. The damn Colossus has a clear shot at you the whole time, and you've got Geth coming in from both sides. The left gives you some cover from the Colossus, but your ass is hanging out for the Geth. That's how I got shot.
We need to get to Tally. Got any ideas?
Just one. I'm not moving so well, but I can still pull a trigger. I got a rocket launcher that the sun hasn't tried yet. You move in close. I'll keep the Colossus busy. Maybe even drop its shields. With luck, you'll be able to finish it off.
You've done enough, Rieger. You don't need to throw your life away.
Wasn't asking your permission. My job is to keep Tally safe. This is our best shot.
We don't have enough people on our side for you to take one for the team. Stand down.
I'm not gonna stand there while you run into enemy fire. They killed my whole squad.
And if you want to honor your squad, watch my back. I need you here in case they bring reinforcements.
All right, Shepard. We'll do it your way. Hit him for me. Keep us alive.
Hostile! Take the shot.
All right.
Just a second. I locked the door to keep more guests from getting inside. There, that should do it.
All right.
Affirmative.
Just in case. Alright, I think we got everything. I'm gonna just saw something. Oh no. More power cells over here. Again, a situation where I could have used my heavy weapons, but I completely forgot about this collector particle beam I've been carrying around.
Thank you, Shepard. If not for you, I would never have made it out of this room. This whole mission has been a disaster. I wish I'd joined you back on Freedom's Progress, but I couldn't let anyone take my place on something this risky.
A lot of Quarians lost their lives here. Was it worth it?
I don't know, Shepard. It wasn't my call. The Admiralty Board believed the information here was worth sacrificing all our lives for. I have to believe that they know what's best.
I didn't ask what some admiral thought. I asked what you thought.
A lot of people died here. Some of them were my friends. All of them were good at their jobs. That damn data better be worth it. The price was too high.
What can you tell me about your research here?
Haystrom's sun is destabilizing. Back when this was a Quarian colony, it was a normal star. It shouldn't change that quickly.
Any idea what's destabilizing the sun?
If I had to guess, I'd say that it was dark energy affecting the interior of the star. The effect is similar to when stars blow off mass to enter a red giant phase. But Haystrom's sun is far too young for this to be natural.
Whatever the reason, I'm glad I could help. Once you deliver that data, I could use you on the Normandy.
I promised to see this mission through. I did. I can leave with you and send the data to the fleet. And if the admirals have a problem with it, they can go to hell. I just watched the rest of my team die.
Maybe not the whole rest of your team, ma'am.
Rieger, you made it.
Your old captain's as good as you said. Damn Colossus never stood a chance.
If need be, the Normandy will get you out of here, Rieger.
The Geth didn't damage our ship. As long as we get out of here before reinforcements show up, we'll be fine.
Actually, I won't be going with you. I'm joining Commander Shepard.
I'll pass the data to the Admiralty Board and let them know what happened. She's all yours now, Shepard. Keep her safe.
Yay! Sally! Sally is a cool character, but unfortunately not someone we will probably be using very often in this run-through. Not only because, like in the first game, she's an engineer and shares a lot of abilities with us, but because her power respawn times are so long in this game, it makes her hard to use in any situation.
Looking forward to having you on the team. Your engineering expertise will really benefit the mission.
I don't know who you are, but Cerberus threatened the security of the migrant fleet. Don't make nice.
That's why you're here, Tally. I need people who aren't Cerberus. People I can trust.
I wasn't part of what happened to the migrant fleet, but I understand your distrust. I hope we'll get past that as we work together.
I assumed that you were undercover, Shepard. Maybe even planning to blow Cerberus up. If that's the case, I'll loan you a grenade. Otherwise, I'm here for you, not for them.
If it helps, check out the Normandy while you're here. We've gotten a few upgrades.
I'll get Talizora the necessary security clearance to access our systems.
Please do. I can't be part of your team if I don't know how the ship works. Remember, Shepard, these people thought enslaving Thorian creepers and Rachni was a good idea. I'll be in engineering.
Don't forget to introduce yourself to Edie, the ship's new artificial intelligence.
That's a good call, Jacob. I don't know what good you thought that was going to do, Jacob. Alright, well, we got a few weapon upgrades there. Take the heavy pistol. Most definitely. The armor-piercing heavy pistol. and assault rifle damage. Which unlocked assault rifle penetration. We will take that too. Alright, we are all fully upgraded again.
I had a wonderful chat with your friend Tally. She's not what I expected from her psych report. I like her.
Tally's a good friend. We've been through a lot together.
My female intuition says she wants to be more than just good friends.
What makes you say that?
It's in her body language. How she turns to you when you enter the room. How she watches your every move. Corians are so fascinating to me. But they also make me a little sad.
Why do they make you sad?
Their environment suits are so beautiful, but with their immune systems, they're trapped inside. I wonder what they look like under those helmets, or what their skin feels like under those suits.
Is there anything I should know?
You have unread messages at your private terminal. Anything else, Commander?
That'll be all.
I'll be here if you need anything. Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal.
I don't need to do anything with them. An important request from Mr. Ganak Ejhal, Esquire. Dear Sir or Madam, having consulted with my colleagues at the Citadel, I have the privilege to request your assistance to transfer a large quantity of Prothean technology uncovered at Ilos, believing these materials to be a hazardous danger they were locked in quarantine. Even though the tests revealed that the fields were groundless, the quarantine remains in effect until one can pay for a permit to request a reclassification from the Cultural Ministry. Knowing of your interest in Prothean technology, I would be happy to deliver most of it into its hands, keeping less than half of it myself. As a Batarian, I cannot engage in Council official activities, but if you transfer the 20,000 credits required to me, this exchange could be made in your name, enabling us both to profit from this happy accident. Please reply urgently with your credit transfer account information. Best regards, Ganak Ejhal. Like a Nigerian prince, just needing your money? Transfer request approved. From Admiralty Board, Migrant Fleet. Commander Shepard, per Tali Zoran Vasnima's request included with her delivery data from Haystrom, the Admiralty Board has approved her transfer to your command. She has been informed that additional duties to the Migrant Fleet may still be necessary on occasion, but has been given extended leeway to determine when her mission with you is considered complete. This choice was hers, but your role as her de facto captain during her privilege pilgrimage may have caused her to be more susceptible to your requests. The Admiralty Board trusts that you will treat your new crew member with the respect due an honored member of the fleet. Should any harm come to her due to negligence on your part, this board will take severe and appropriate action. Admiral Whale Zora, Migrant Fleet Admiralty Board. Oh, Whale Zora, that would be her father, the Admiral.
It's great to see Tali on board, Commander, just like old times. It is her, right? I mean, because with the mask, it's... Ah, never mind.
I assume everything is going well up here?
Good for now. Fractured my thumb on the mute, but I think I made my point.
That's it for now.
See you, Commander.
Yes, Shepard.
That's all for now.
Logging you out, Shepard.
All right. We will run back up to the cabin quick, feed the fish. I'll get back down to the crew quarters. Nothing to say here again. And this is Samara, right?
Hey, got a minute? The Normandy runs so quietly. I'm not used to hearing my footsteps when I walk. One of the girls in navigation thinks she might be pregnant. Even aboard a Cerberus vessel, life finds a way. I have to say, that Jacob? He seems pretty intense. I wonder if he likes Japanese girls with a penchant for kleptomania. Come back later. I'm sure I'll have more to talk about.
Who wouldn't like Japanese girls with a penchant for kleptomania? I mean, come on. Isn't that what we're all looking for?
Commander, what can I do for you?
Anything I should know regarding the Normandy?
The crew's working well, and the ship appears to be performing.
You have a minute, Miranda?
There's a lot to do, Shepard.
I'll let you work.
Of course, Commander.
Alright, in that case, I don't think there's anything more to do here. And back down to engineering. Talk to Zaid and Ken and Gabby and Hallie.
Gabby, you'd say the Normandy is a she, not a he, right?
Of course. The Normandy's the sweetest girl there is.
And Edie's a she. Tally's definitely a she.
What are you getting at, Kenneth?
I'm just saying I'm feeling a wee bit threatened here. A lot of female energy, and I'm just one man.
You're such a dick.
See? Look where your mind went. I've got to watch out for myself. What can we do for you, Commander?
Carrier.
Will do, Commander. What can we do for you, Commander?
Carrier.
Will do, Commander. What can we do for you, Commander?
Carrier.
Will do, Commander.
Shepard, what can I do for you?
Is the new Normandy giving you any trouble?
Please, Shepard, I'm a Quarian. Give me a chunk of scrap metal, a circuit board, and some Element Zero, and I'll have it making precision jumps. I was worried about working with Cerberus engineers, but they know what they're doing, and they've been very polite.
Can you do anything to give the Normandy an edge over a collector ship?
Definitely. With the right supplies, I can fortify our shields. The collectors cut through the Normandy's barriers immediately last time. My upgrades might give us a better chance.
Cyclone multi-core shielding. The rapidly oscillating kinetic obstructions of cyclonic barrier technology are added to the ship. This should help the ship survive blasts like that that destroyed the first Normandy. Alright, we will take it.
Before the Geth revolt 300 years ago,
Guess I forgot to go through this while we were on the mission.
Which threatened premature eruption into a red giant. As a scientific outpost of minimal military value, Haystrom was ill-equipped to repel Geth forces during the insurrection and fell quickly under their control. Captured Geth planetary survey data indicates that despite sustaining damage during the war, Haystrom's architecture remains as it was 300 years ago, preserving a Quarian architectural style that no longer exists anywhere else in the galaxy. Because Haystrom's sun has overwhelmed the planet's protective magnetosphere, humans foolhardy enough to venture into Geth-controlled Haystrom must exercise extreme caution. Minutes of radiation exposure will overload shields, and hours of exposure will kill. Furthermore, solar output renders surface-to-orbit communication nearly impossible. Cyclonic Barrier Technology, CBT, attempts to solve the higher-end limitations of traditional kinetic barriers. Traditional barriers cannot block high-level kinetic energy such as disruptor torpedoes because torpedo mass effect fields add mass. The CBT violently slaps aside rather than halting incoming linear force. By rotationally firing their mass effect field projectors, ships create rapidly oscillating kinetic barriers instead of static ones. Shooting through the CBT is like trying to shoot at a target inside a spinning ball. Significant drawbacks to current CBT configuration prevent its use on anything other than frigates and fighters. Its many high-frequency sensors and emitters require frequent maintenance and replacement. A partially damaged CBT can endanger its operator, who is surrounded by rotating mass effect fields skewing in unpredictable directions. However, if an emitter is damaged, the CBT becomes a traditional shield array, making it effective during opening volleys.
All right.
Shepard, what can I do for you?
How's the Normandy running?
Say what you will about Cerberus. They know how to build ships. The Normandy's running even better than before. I don't know if it can stand up to a collector attack, though. I'm researching some ideas that might help.
Have you got time to talk?
We didn't really have time to chat while taking out Geth on Haystrom, did we? I can't believe so many people died. Thank you again for getting Rieger out alive. All for data about stars blowing up. I hope the Admiralty Board gets some use out of it.
Have you heard any word about Cal Rieger? Did he survive his injuries?
He sent me a message. It looks like he'll make a full recovery. Anytime you get a suit puncture, it's a matter of luck. Rieger got out with a relatively minor infection.
Tell me about the fleet's Admiralty Board.
It's one of two major political powers among my people. The admirals make decisions related to defense or needing immediate action. They also handle major criminal charges, like treason. The other political power is the Conclave, a group of representatives from each ship. They make most of our laws and fleet decisions.
Any news yet on the data you sent?
I'm not likely to hear anything for a while, or on an unsecured channel, for that matter.
That's fair enough.
Any trouble settling back in on the Normandy?
I like the quiet. I miss the old faces, though. Presley, Engineer Adams, all of them. Doesn't seem right having Cerberus in charge of this ship. Are you sure working for them is the right thing to do?
I fully expect them to betray us at some point, and we'll be ready.
I'm glad to hear that, Shepard. Just let me know how I can help. For now, I should get back to work. Thanks for coming by.
Back for more? I was trying to remember how many Cerberus operatives I've killed. Lost track around 50. Guess your elusive man's big on forgiveness. Get a knife stuck in the right way, and you can pull that plate right off a Krogan's head. is the best way to get a Krogan to
talk. I think we've circled back around on both Zaid and Kasumi, and we're getting repeats. Forget how many squad mates there are in this. Saeed and Grunt, that's a very interesting combination. Passive. Ugh. What do you want to do? Zayn. Get him to Mercenary Warlord. Yeah, weapon damage. More important for Zayn than health. Let's see, what do we want to do with Grunt? So we'll upgrade it to Inferno. Because Warp does a lot of the same things, and I have Warp ammo. And the upgrade is passive. And Grunt's health regen is one of his best. It's what makes him such an awesome tank in this game, so we'll definitely go with Krogan Pureblood. I don't want him on a scimitar.
Excuse me, my sources indicate you were in a warehouse recently. Did you by any chance forward a questionable shipping note to a Mr. Thax?
It looked suspicious, so I passed it on.
I'm a representative for Mr. Thax. He's very grateful to you. Please accept this as a gift for bringing the shipping irregularities to his attention.
What happens to the shipping agent who is cheating Thax?
That depends on how sincere her apology is, and how willing she is to correct a mistake.
Do you want help finding the person who cheated Thax?
Thank you, but that won't be necessary. Mr. Thax will be making a series of polite calls. Hopefully, a confrontation will not be required.
It was my pleasure.
Have a pleasant day.
And after all that, now we just leveled up again. So, yep, nothing. All right, guys, well, that will be it for this episode. Thank you for tuning in. Make sure that you watch the rest of this series. We still got a lot of Mass Effect to go. Check out the store, Nicknack's Full Frontal Assault, and check us out on Facebook and on Twitter. Also, make sure you check out the Daily Grind every weekday, 8 to 8:30. I know Mike really enjoys having people tune into that. So, thanks for watching, everyone. I will see you next time.